Good morning, friends. In the last lectures, we completed the chapters unit 4th, that is design of the shaft and couplings. So today I am starting your unit 5th, is the design of the threaded joint, power screw and welded joints. So in this unit, this is design above, actually this is also big unit, design above the threaded joints, design above the welded joints, design above the riveted joint, and design above the power screw. So that's why we'll spare 3-4 classes on, or 4-5 classes on threaded joint, riveted joint, welded joint, and against a power screw, means near about 15 classes requires for this unit also. So this is big chapter, and this because our syllabus is vast, that's why first I start, this is design up of the threaded joint, design of threaded joint. So in the design of the threaded joints, so three types of the joints, threaded joints, riveted joint, and welded joints. You can call as a riveted joint and welded joint as a permanent joint, and this is joint, design of the threaded joints you can call as a temporary joint, because in the threaded joint we can quickly assemble the two parts and disassemble the two parts. So this is the advantages. The cost of the assembly and disassembly of the joint, this is less as compared to welded joints and riveted joint. This is the advantages of the threaded joints. So if we are compare this threaded joints with the welded joints, there is no any thermostasis induced in the joints, and the time requires for assembling and disassembling is very less. And main disadvantage in the threaded joint is the, so after studying up of the welded joints, we can study against, means what are the advantages and disadvantages of the welded joints and riveted joints, or compare with. So after studying up of the three joints or two joints, so only briefly, means introductions of the threaded joints. What is the main advantage of the threaded joints? That is the this is the quick assembling and disassembling of the joints. The times requires and the cost of the threaded joint is less. Disadvantage, you can call as a disadvantage, means because for fluctuating loads, if the load is the fluctuating, so the threaded joint is weak, means chances of the loose of the bolts during the fluctuating loads. And next is the this threaded joint is less stronger or strength as compared to welded joint and riveted joint. So this is the advantages and disadvantages of the, some of the important advantages and disadvantages of the threaded joints. So first we'll see, means this is introductions. In introductions, as you know, so in the threaded joints, three parts importance, that is, first is the bolt or screw, next is nut, and third is the washer. You may be aware what is mean of the bolt, screws and nut. So what are the different types of the bolt, screws, and what are the different types of the nuts and washers. So what is the functions of the, means what is the functions of the washers? So this washers, that is placed between the joint, which is to be of the machine parts, and head bolt or nut in between, means under the bolt head. Suppose this is bolt head, here washers we can use. So the hole of the washers, so this is slightly greater than the diameter of the bolt. According to the bolts, if the this size of the bolt is the M16, the hole size of the washers, this may be 17 mm, 18 mm, according to the, because some of the play is required. So what is the functions of the washers that distribute the pressures around the which are coming around the this bolt, and that is distributed over the large area. This is the functions of the washers, means for distribution of the force on the large area. This is washers. What is the functions of the nut? Nuts, that is the tightening of the assembly by fixing, means by keeping bolt as a stationary. Now we can tighten the nut. We can tighten the nut. So the torque is applied on the nut, if the bolt and nut. So what is difference between bolt and screw? Which parts you can call as a bolt and which part you can call as a screw? Generally bolts. So in the bolts, so this head may be hexagonal, head may be hexagonal. So this head may be hexagonal. Likewise, bolt may be round and it may be slotted type. So this type of the slot. This is rounded type. And this is through bolt or hexagonal head. This is rounded head, maybe Allen head. And this is such type of the, again this threaded portions is the required. Allen head bolt. So bolt may be through bolt may be tap bolt. So such type of the bolts are called as bolt. Screw. So this is screw. Here the torque is to be, what is difference between bolt and screw? In the bolt and difference between bolt and screw, bolt is to be keep as a stationary and nut is to be tightened. If this is bolt and this is nut, so this nut is to be, torque is to be applied on the nut. And in the screw, so generally screws, so the other parts having a more thickness, and there you can insert this screw and you can apply the torque on the head. So this is without generally nuts, and this is with generally nut. This is the difference between nut and bolts. Screws and bolts. So in the bolts keep stationary and screw that is rotating about its own axis, and torque is to be applied on the head of the, so such type of the or called as the screw. This is Allen head, or maybe bolt. This is bolt or screw. Allen, this is called actually bolts, or maybe you can call as a screw, because here torque is to be applied on the head in this case. Next is the stud. So here's again this threaded portion, this is through bolt. Half thread bolt means, in the half thread bolts, so threading portions, so such type of the bolts are called as half thread bolt. And next is the stud. For stud, the thread on the both sides, so such type of the are called as a stud. And this can be fixed in one portions, and this is maybe plate, and this is fixed and plate, and here you can apply the, or you can tighten the nut. So this is the both sided is the thread, so that is called as a stud. This is half threaded, and this diameters, so generally greater than the this threaded portions. So in the threaded joints, again terminology of the threads. Suppose this is Allen, this is threaded, hexagonal bolt. So in the hexagonal bolt, so these diameters are called as major diameters. And this diameters, and this is actually called as a root, and this is crest, and this portion is the called as a crest, and this is root. So this diameter is the minor diameter. And this diameters, this is given. So this is imaginary diameters. This is pitch diameter. The distance between the two threads are called as pitch. This is nothing but the pitch. So this is terminology important. So in the threaded joints, so what are the different types of the stresses induced in the threaded joints? So in the threaded joints, the stresses may be induced, that is direct shear stress, stresses induced may be tensile stress, direct shear stress, and direct shear stress, and this is torsional shear stress, and maybe in the some of the cases crushing stress. This is nothing but the compressive stress. This is also induced in some of the cases, but this is important. So as you know, tensile stresses induced means how you can calculate the tensile stresses. So for tensile stress, we can use the formula sigma t equal to one minute. And direct tensile stress is equal to sigma t. Sigma t equal to how you can calculate it? Sigma t equal to yield tensile stress, sigma yt divided by factor of safety. And this is equal to, what is formula? Load upon area, and this load upon pi by 4. DC is the, this is the core diameter or minor diameter. DC is the minor diameters. And for direct shear stress, again, this is tau equal to 2 sigma yt divided by factor of safety. Again, this P by A, and this is P divided by pi by 4. DC squares. And for torsional shear stress, we can use tau equal to 16t divided by pi d cube. And this is for torsional stress equal to. We can use this formula. And this is torsional shear stress, just basic formula. We will see what type of the torsional shear stress is induced. And crushing stress equal to P divided by projected area. And this projected area equal to D into thickness above the flange. So this is least important. So these are the importance. What are the different types of the stresses induced in the bolt? So first, according to the arrangement of the threaded joints, first we will study according to the arrangement. This is eccentrically thread bolted joints in shear. So you can take any headings. Suppose this arrangement, this is a plate and this is a beam, and here plate is to be fixed, and this plate if such arrangements, and this number of bolts 1, 2, 3, and this is 4, and your load is applied. This is P, and the center of gravity, this is because this is center of gravity, and this distance equal to E, and this distance for such type of the cases, if the arrangement of the bolts or positions above the bolts such type of the symmetricals, so there is no necessary to calculate the center of gravity. Otherwise center of gravity is to be calculated if such type of the arrangements. So here's this distance is the Y bar, and this distance is the X bar. So Y bar or X bar, we can calculate summations above the A into X divided by summation of A, and this is nothing but A1 X1 coordinate, and this X1 is the coordinate means centered above. If this is suppose first bolt, so what is the and this distance, or what is this distance? Likewise, A1, A2, X2 plus A3, X3 and so on divided by A1 plus A2 plus A3. So first we have to calculate what is the positions above the center of gravity. Similarly, Y bar also equal to area, and this is A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 plus A3 Y3 plus summations, and this is A1 plus A2 plus A3. So calculations of the center of gravity you studied in the applied mechanics. So by using this formula you can calculate the what is the center of gravity of the assembling above the threaded joints. So that is to be first calculate. So after that, if the load is such type of the loadings, so then because this total loads that is directly comes on the board, so that's why first steps primary shear stress in, because yes, each bolts, because yes, two types of the stresses induced. One is the direct shear stress, because this load is perpendicular to the axis of the bolt, so that's why direct shear stress. and this because of the eccentricity, this will try to rotate. So that's why torsional shear stress induced. So that's why I can split here a primary shear stress and secondary shear stress. So primary shear stress equal to this is 1, 2. We can use notations P1 dash equal to P2 single dash equal to P3 single dash. Here we assume the size up of the bolts is same, and because this load is the equally divided into 4 bolts, so that's why primary shear stress equal to this P divided by, in this case, number of bolts. So for this case, here 4 number of the bolts, that's why P divided by, you can say this is 4 for this case only. So this number of the bolts may be 2, maybe 3, maybe 5, maybe 6, 7, etc. So for this case, so that's why for understanding purpose, I write here, and this is 4. Now suppose this is shear force, because this is shear force total, secondary shear force on each bolt is P1 double dash. This is single dash, and this is P1 double dash, P2 double dash, P3 double dash, and P4 double dash. So this is for first bolt, second bolt, and third bolt, and fourth bolts. So that's why now the center of gravity for this, center of gravity, suppose this is center of gravity, first bolt to second bolt, and this is third, and this is fourth bolt. Now we can join these bolts, positions above the bolts, and suppose this distance is the R1, R2, R3, and R4, and R1 is the distance, R is the distance between center of gravity of joint of threaded joint JO and bolts. So that's why this is R1, R2. Now this C is the proportionality constant, so that's why this is, now because this will try to rotate, so this is for here 2 moments, and this is, and another is the, because of all the forces acting, so this is opposite. So that's why we can write here P into E, this is 1 moments, and for to balance this moments, so here 4 moments, and that is P1 double dash multiplied by R1 plus P2 double dash R2 plus P3 double dash R3 plus P4 double dash R4. And here this distance, this is proportional to P1 double dash equal to, is proportional to this distance CR1, or P2 double dash, this is CR2, and P3 double dash, this is CR3, and this is P4 double dash, this is equal to CR4. Suppose this is first equation, and this equation is the second equation. Right, now put value of the P1 double dash, P2 double dash in this first equation. This derivation is given in the books, because limitations above the space, directly I am writing now, this is P into E this is equal to, now P1 double dash equal to, we can write this is C into R1 and this R1. So directly, can I write here as R1 squares, because R1 squares, and this is CR2 squares, CR3 square plus CR4 square. This is clear. Now by take combined means P into E, this is R1 square, R2 square, R3 square plus R4 square, C equal to. So suppose this is third equation. Now put value of the C in second equations. So P1 double dash equal to, you will get this is P into E into R1 divided by R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square plus R4 squares. Similarly, P2 double dash equal to P into E into R2, R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square plus R4 square. And similarly, so this is secondary shear force acting on the each bolt. Now, what is the next steps? Now, this is limitations of the space. I erase this. Now, by using vector addition methods, we have to add this primary shear force and secondary shear force. So, this is arrangement. And suppose we are assuming direct shear force acting on the each bolts. So this is center of gravity. First, second, this is third, and this is fourth. And this is center of gravity. So that's why here, assume in the sum of the books, so intensity of the primary shear force acting on the each bolts, so that is assumed upwards. So this is P1 single dash, P2 double dash, P3 double dash, single dash, P4 single dash. So by using vector additions methods, so this is important, try to understand this. So the directions of the each shear force actings, because force actings, this is the force acting, this P. So that equally, assume that is equally divided by or equally shared by the four bolts. Now secondary shear force acting means this is P2, likewise P3 double dash and P4 double dash equal to. That is, so this calculate, so what may be the forces, so that depends on the distance. If the distance is equal, you will get same values. So after that, because this is the directions, and so that's why this is rotating, this because of the force, so that is rotating, and shear force, that is opposite, so that's why this, and this angle is the 90 degree. This is P3 double dash. Here's this is force, and this is P2 double dash, this is single dash, and here P1 double dash. In this case, this will try to rotate, so that's why this is P4 double dash. Now what will be the now resultant force? So this is the resultant force. this is P2. In this case, this is P3, and here you may be get yes, this is P1, and in this case, this is the resultant force is the P4. So that is to be calculate resultant force. So after that, we can calculate the resultant forces. So these are the this is the methods for finding out of the resultant force. We will see how that calculate. So note down today's first problems, that is for asymmetrically threaded bolted joints in shear. In this case, both stresses are shear stresses, that's why directly we can add. There is no need of the use principal stresses or shear stress. So note down first problems. A steel plate subjected to a force of 5 kN and fixed to a channel by means of three identical bolts as shown in figure. The bolts are made of plain carbon steel 45C8, sigma yt equal to 380 newton per mm squares, and the factor of safety is 3, and the factor of safety is 3. Specify the size of bolts. This is given. This distance is force acting, this is 5 kN. This distance 200 mm. This is 75, this is 75, and this distance 30. This distance is the 30. So first, we'll calculate this means this is tau equal to 0.5 sigma yt divided by a factor of safety, and this is 380 divided by factor of safety 3, means tau equal to 190 divided by 3, right? So this is 63.33 mega Pascal. Now primary shear force acting on each bolt equal to P divided by, what is formula? Number of bolts, and this loads 5 kilonewtons, 5000 divided by 3. This is 66 Newton. This is clear. Now what is to be calculate? Our secondary shear force acting on each bolts equal to, now this is P1 single dash, P2 single dash, this is P3 dash. Now this is P1 double dash equal to C into R1. Similarly, P2 double dash CR2 CR3. Right? So first we'll calculate C equal to what is formula? P into E divided by R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square. P equal to 5000. E equal to 200 plus 30 plus 75. 200 plus 30 plus 75. This is 75 divided by. Now this R1 equal to this distance, because the center of gravity, and this will try to rotate, and this is 75 square plus R2 distance, because this is about center of gravity, 0 square plus 75 square. We'll add that 200 plus 30 plus means 305 multiplied by 5000 divided by 2 divided by 75 square equal to, and this is 135.55. So what is unit? This is because this is force multiplied by this distance. This is Newton MEM, and this is MEM square. That's why this will get cancelled. And this unit, Newton per mm. This is clear. That's why now I can write P1 double dash, because this distance is the P1 double dash equal to P3 double dash equal to C into R1. C equal to 135.55. R1 distance. This distance equal to, this is 75 and this is 75. So that's why this is 75 multiplied by 75. this is 10,066 newton. This is clear. Now draw this is free body diagrams. Primary shear force acting on each bolts. This is P3 dash, P2 dash, and this is P1 dash. Now, secondary shear force acting on the each bolts. So, because this is tried to rotate, so that's why on the bolt number 3, because this is tried to rotate, so that's why this is P3 and double dash. Here's P2 dash, no force acting, and here's because this will try to rotate likewise and opposite to secondary shear force, so that's why this is P2 double dash. Now, because here this is positive, or you can consider this is both are opposite, and this is on the same. So, by observing free body diagram, for arrangement we conclude that more load on bolt 3, more load on bolt number 3, because that's why chances of failure of bolt 3 is more. This is clear. That's why design is based on bolt 3. You can say 3. Directly, now we can add total shear force, or you can say resultant shear force equal to, now by vector additions directly we can add P3 single dash, P3 double dash, and this is 166.66 plus 10,166 plus, now this is 11,833 newton. So that's why now apply basic formula for shear force equal to P divided by area, and this shear force equal to 66.66, force equal to 11,833 divided by pi by 4 dc square, and dc is the, and this is the core diameters or list diameters, and this is equal to 33.4 divided by pi into tau. Directly I am calculating this, multiplied by 4 divided by pi and divided by 66.66, and this is under root, and this is 15.03 mm. Now diameter of the threads means major diameters, means this is D equal to relations DC divided by, this is standard relations 0.8. D is the major diameter of the bolts, and this is 15.03 divided by 0.8. So this is 18.79, means diameter of the bolts you can consider this M20. So this M is indicates size above the thread is the mm size, and this is the 20 is the minor diameter or major diameter above the bolts. So this is the designations above the bolts. Now you can understand how we can solve the problems related with the design above the bolts, the according to when the load is the eccentrically, and that is the directly perpendicular to the axis of the bolts. So what is the methods that design procedures we studied, and after that one problems related with the this I solved, because if I am solving the next problems that requires more time. Otherwise, I can solve next problems. So note down, because still 15 minutes remaining. So this is today's second problem. The structural connections, shown in figure, is subjected to an eccentric force P of 10 kilonewton with an eccentricity of 500 mm. The center distance between the bolts 1 and 2, is 200 mm, and center distance between bolt number 1 and 3 is 150 mm. All the bolts are identical. The bolts are made from plain carbon steel. 30C8 sigma mt 400 and factor of safety is 2.5 and factor of safety is 2.5. Determine the size of the bolts. Determine the size of bolts. Here figure given. Bolt 1, 2, this is 3 given, this is 4, the center distance 150 and this distance 200. Force acting, this is phi equal to 10,000. Newton. So I split this problem into three parts. This is eccentricity. This distance is given 500 mm, right? That's why directly now without writing theory weights means I will calculate most allowable shear stress. Allowable shear stress equal to, this is 400, 0.5 multiplied by 400 divided by 2.5, and this is 200 divided by 2.5. This is 80 mega pascals. Now primary shear force acting, this is P1 single dash, directly I am writing because today for this problems I have less times. P2 single dash, this is primary shear force acting on each bolts equal to 10,000 divided by total number of the bolts 4. So the each means load shared by the each bolt, this is equal to 2,500 newtons. Now this is P1 double dash, P2 double dash, P3 double dash, because this distance is the same. So that's why directly I can write this is equal to C into R, and this is R1 likewise. And R1 equal to, how we can calculate? Because this is 75 and this is 200. Directly I am writing, this is 75 square plus 100 square. This is 125 mm. This distance equal to R1 equal to, R3 equal to, R2 equal to, R4 equal to 125 mm. C equal to, how you can calculate C equal to? P into E divided by R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square plus R4 squares. So directly I can write this is 10,000, E equal to, this is 500 and this is, distance is the same. So that's why 4 into 125 squares. C equal to. And this is equal to C equal to 80 Newton per mm. And now P2 double dash, and this is secondary shear force acting on each bolts, P4 double dash equal to, this is C into R equal to 125, because this distance 125, that's why multiplied by 125, and this is 10,000. This is clear? 10,000. Now, yes, I have to make arrangement. And this is 1, 2, and this is 3, and this is 4th. So this is center of gravity. Primary shear force acting on the each bolts. This is P1 single dash, P2 single dash, P4 single dash, P3 single dash. Now, this distance, this is P2 double dash, and this is opposite to, so that's why this is P4 double dash. Yes, this is P3 double dash, and here's P1 double dash. So that's why, yes, the force acting is, this is P2. And this is P4. This distance equal to P4. Now we have to calculate this P2. So this angles is important. Because this angle, suppose this angle equal to theta, and this is phi. Now we have to resolve these forces along, this is vertically, so that's why we have to calculate these angles theta, and this distance is the tan theta equal to, so this front side, this distance is the 75, and this horizontal distance, this distance, try to understand this. This theta, this is 75, and this is 100. That's why theta equal to. Tan inverse, 75, tan or tan inverse, this is 0.75, 36.86 degree. Now if this angles is the phi, so this is we can for resultants this P2 equal to, because force acting on the second bolt is more or fourth bolt is more, so that's why this is P2 single dash P2 double dash square plus 2 P2 single dash P2 double dash into, if we consider this is theta angles cos 30 means that becomes this is vertical, so that's why P2 equal to this is P2 single dash 2500 square plus P2 double dash 10,000 square multiplied by 10,000 multiplied by cos 36.86 P2 equal to directly 12093 newtons. This is clear. Now shear force equal to this P2 divided by pi by 4 dc square, or dc equal to 12093 multiplied by 4 divided by pi into shear stress equal to, now this is 80, that's why 12093 multiplied by 4 divided by pi divided by 80, and this is under root dc equal to 13.87 mm, and d equal to diameter of the bolts by using formula dc divided by 0.8, 13.87 divided by 0.8 means size of the bolts requires, I think, M18. Now this is 17.34, so that's why we request M18. This is size of the bolt. This is your expected answers. So I think you understand how we can design the threaded joints. So this is one arrangement. So in the next class we will see some of the problems related with the eccentrically loaded joints when means due to shear stress, and after that next type of the so I think 4-5 lectures that is I will spend on the threaded joints. So that's why today I stop here, and we will continue the remaining problems in the next class. Thank you.